Welcome back, everybody, to 7 Days and I'm an Old Guy Gaming, and this is the Insane Series, where we play on insane difficulties. Zombies are all set, the nightmare speed, and we have a hell of a fun time doing it. All right, so I have spent quite a bit of time, I don't know, maybe close to an hour, probably, in real life, mining down here in the mine, and I thought I would bring you guys back and just kind of show you where we're at with the mine. This mine has all four of the ores. We got a little patch of nitrate over here. We got iron on this end. We've got coal in the middle. And then we have lead on this side. So it's really a pretty ideal mining situation, you know, having all those ores. Plus the fact that, you know, nitrate's the thing that we needed the least of because we have the most of it back at the base. So I've been, you know, drinking coffee, taking the candies and stuff like that. And we've ended up with a little over 3 stacks of coal, almost 4 stacks of iron, about 1¾ stacks or so of lead, and then almost 4 stacks of stone. So pretty good haul there, pretty good haul. Okay, so what we're going to do, and the nitrate, we have 1,320 nitrate, which is fine because I have a full stack and then some back at the base anyway. So what I want to do in this episode is I want to go do a little bit of exploring, and I also want to see if we can find some more cornfields, and if we're really lucky, another potato patch or two, because I really want to get that stuff going, so we can start making the good food. I can make sham chowder, I can make hobo stew, I can make pumpkin bread, and a few other things like that. So, you know, I mean, we can wait until the garden matures a few more times and we harvest it a few more times, but, you know, that's going to take quite some time. So I would rather, you know, go look for that. And in the process, we can also, you know, do a little bit more exploration too. So we've been all the way as far east as we can go. This is the ocean here. And we've been far enough to the west to know that it's, you know, it's burned biome. And then the map stops there. So the ocean probably starts somewhere around in here, would be my guess. Though there is a pretty sizable town. We haven't really been north, but based upon me dragging the map, we're already pretty close to the northern border. So south is really the majority of the map that we haven't uncovered. And my guess is that, you know, we're going to probably find a wasteland biome, but we haven't found the snow biome yet either. So we could do that, but you know, the main goal, of course, is going to be looking for corn and potatoes. And we should somewhere in this map. I found a mine. That's a military bunker. I don't remember where it was. I should have marked it, but I didn't. You know, where we could get mushrooms. So, you know, we're looking for shrooms and that sort of thing too. And we'll just go on a little bit of a road trip and do a little bit of exploration, you know, kind of change things up a little bit from the usual, you know, doing the quest. We'll, of course, continue doing the quest too, but I wanted to do something different and also useful at the same time. I'm going to very quickly here start my permanent horde base. I really have been kind of holding out for an auger before I do that, but I don't know. It's probably, I mean, I've got maximum mining skills, and if you, you know, throw coffee in there and the, you know, the candies and stuff like that, I can do pretty good even just manually. So I think we probably better start thinking about getting going on that probably after day 42. We're going to use our horde base as it is now after, whoops, I didn't mean to do that. After day 42, thought I heard something. So, or at day 42, sorry, I'm a little distracted here. I want to put these back in place for the next time. There we go. And then after that, the horde's going to really, really start getting nasty. In fact, what is our thingamadoodle? Game stage 105, yeah. And I'd like to have the new base in place. I mean, we could probably do 49 also, but after 49, I would definitely like to have the new base in place. So that's kind of the general plan here. So what I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to go back to the base and I'm going to drop off all these resources and get, you know, get smelting and that sort of thing. And then when I'm ready to set out, what I will do is I'll bring you guys back at that point and then we'll go from there. Okay, so see you in a bit. All right, guys, we're back at the base, and I've got the industry cranking. Everything is like going to full bore. So this guy's doing stone, and let's actually get some more cement going too. This guy's got two full, well, it was when I started, almost two full stacks of iron smelting up. This one's working on brass and lead, and this one's working on iron as well for more steel production. Both of these guys are not working on cement because they're are concrete because they're done for the moment until we get more cement cooked up. But I got a nice little supply of concrete going up. We're going to need that, of course, for the new horde base that we're going to make. These guys are working on gunpowder, both of them. And I have got a lot of stuff that I need to get sold to the trader. So I think what I'm going to do is get everything repaired, mod up the stuff that I have, spare mods for. And the other thing we could do, whilst we're at the trader is we could check and see if the trader has, seeds that we still need too. I picked a little bit more corn at this barn right here, I think it is. Yeah, this one, there was a little corn patch behind that I actually hadn't picked. This is where our mine is. So I have two rows, full rows of corn now, but we're still planning on, planting another half a row here. With the other half being hops. Yucca's all done and mature, but I'm not gonna harvest that yucca right now because I already have several stacks of yucca juice on hand. So yeah, that's pretty much where we're at. We have a little bit of aloe that's ripe, but I mean I got a lot of bandages too, so we don't necessarily need to harvest that right at the moment. So let's go ahead and get all this stuff fixed up. We've got to get it repaired, which means we've got to make a crap ton of repair kits. So let's see, we've got a nice little supply of glue here, and we could even make, we have 753 bones to make more glue. Let's see, murky water, that's over here. We're going to need some murky water though. I've got 49 jars there. We could make more jars here, but we're going to have to put some sand in there. I'm not gonna do that right now, but maybe I'll do that on the next casual construction episode because we have plenty now. So I'm gonna convert all of this into duct tape. So let's grab that. So that'll make 128. So 64 in here, and we'll do 64 in here. Okay, so we'll get that going. I have four duct tape already made up and one extra glue. I guess we could make a duct tape in our own inventory as well. And then we need iron ingots for repair kits. So we've got a full stack here. Let's just grab half of those for the moment and get going on repair kits. Okay, so, yeah, what I'm going to do is, let's take a look. I'm going to do most of this off camera, of course, but let's take a look and see what we have in the way of spare mods. We got a spare iron breaker. I'd like to hang on to that, though, because once we get an auger, I could put it on the auger. And I still want to keep one, for the pick, too. And let's put that on our pick right now, as a matter of fact. I should have done that when we went mining, but I didn't. I like to keep the burning shaft mod on here just because it lights put the place up a little bit better, and of course the ergonomic grip gives us more stamina, so it's really kind of just these two things that I'll typically switch out. So we'll put that up there. Okay, so are we, do we have our armor fully modded? I think we do. We got four pieces on there, four pieces on there, four on there, and three on there, but that's because these two only can hold three slots. Okay, so these don't have the cargo. I don't think I can make the cargo. No, I still can't make that yet. Anyway. Alright, well let's see. We're gonna grab the plating and the customized fittings. I want to keep We're going to make another set of probably light armor, too. I mean, I can always, you know, switch the mods out, which is kind of a pain in the ass, but I'm not going to be really switching armor out constantly. I'll only do it when we change our build, so that kind of doesn't matter a whole lot, I guess. So, let's see. This, we might want to hang on to an extra one of those. We've got an extra of these, but do I don't really have a chainsaw. I mean, I got the one that I want to keep, of course, but I don't have anything else to put them on. There's no motor tools in here. So, yeah, we're just going to, we'll just hang on to those. Muzzle brakes. Okay, I've got a couple wood splitters. And I think the chainsaw already has a wood splitter on it. It does. Okay. So we don't need two more of those. So that we can do something with. Full auto mods. I don't know, man. I kind of like to have at least two of everything, really. Because you just never know what you're going to need or want to do. We certainly don't need two of those. That would be for snowy weather if we ever actually find it. Yeah, okay, so yeah, I guess I just don't really have a whole lot of mods right now, guys, that I want to actually get rid of. We don't need another one of those because we already have those on. We can't use this until we get an actual true rifle, either hunting or sniper. So yeah, the rest of these I'm going to hang on to. Barbed wire mod. Do we have a melee weapon that we're going to sell that we could put that on? Yes, we could put it on here. I'll betcha. Okay, so we'll do that. So right now it's 69. That brought it up to 129. And then if we repair it, it brings it up to 274. Okay, cool. So we got that done. We have this extra mod here. Do we have a helmet of any sort in here? I don't see one. Okay, well, we're just going to have to hang on to that then, too. For now. We got an axe. This axe here. Yeah, this one does 109 block damage versus this new one that I found that does another 17 on top of that, which is pretty damn good. So what we'll do is we will put the this on there. So it's right now it's 984. That brings it up to 1406. What else? Do we have anything else in here that we could put on there to really get the price up? Not really. Okay, well, that's how we'll do it then. That's how we'll do it. It's still, you know, a nice little chunk of change. I got some extra fittings, which we could put on these. This is probably our most valuable between these two things. Armor. That's scrap, so it's not super valuable. That's pretty valuable, too. What? Okay, let's repair all three of these and see which one is the most valuable. So, repair that, and repair this. Okay, so this is 712, that's 1091, and that's 370. Oh, yeah, okay. So this one definitely is the most valuable. So what we'll do is we'll modify that, and we'll put those on there. It's 1091, now it's 1418. And if we put this on, now it's 1745. We almost doubled the value of that by putting just those two mods in there. It's pretty fantastic. Pretty fan-freaking-tastic. Okay. Don't see any other clothing mods in here. So the rest of it I'm probably just going to repair and sell as is. I know I could hang on to it and hold out till we get more mods to make more money, but you know, it's kind of a diminishing returns thing because I don't want to have a bunch of extra shit around. And guys, by the time it's all said and done, when we get to the end of this game, I'm going to have more money than I'm going to know what to do with anyway. So it's just really not that big of a deal. What I don't want to do though is get rid of the mod in here and then not be able to or and not have it when I need it. Damn streamer made me lose my train of thought. Okay, so yeah, let me get the rest of this stuff repaired, loaded up into the 4x4. And then I think what we'll do is we could hit this trader here. And then, you know, maybe kind of go south and swing around and hit this trader. Let me think about this. No, here's what I'm going to do. We're going to hit this trader first. Then we're going to go hit this trader. Then we're going to hit this one and then this one. And then what we'll do is we'll start exploring. We have a tier 4 clear down there anyways. Might as well do that along the way, right? Opening up this territory and going down this way. And all the while, we're going to be looking for corn patches and potato patches. There's probably some that I've passed up already because I wasn't explicitly looking for them. But now we will be looking for those. So, guys, I will bring you back when we get to the traders. And we'll sell our stuff, see how much money we make, and then go from there. All right, guys, we are at the trader. This trader here that's south of our place. So what we're going to do is sell to him, swing up to the desert trader, sell to him, go over to our original trader, Hugh, sell to him, go to this trader, Joel, sell to him, and then probably start exploring to the south. So I've got everything in my inventory. I am going to also put this on here. That brings the price up to $784, which is pretty damn good. We got two more slots here, so let's grab. It doesn't really matter. We're just going to sell everything we can to him. And I have one sugar butts, so let's throw that down and let's do this. Also, nerdies, crafting XP. Nah. I think we'll just keep our lucky looters on. I don't know if that really matters when you're selling or not, but we will.
What can I get you today?
All right, let's take a look at your inventory and start selling. So right now we have 5936 coin. Just want to make sure I start at the right spot here so I'm not selling something I don't want to. Everything pretty much on the two rows at the top is my own inventory that I don't want to sell. Okay, let's do this. All right, so we ended up with basically a full stack of coin and then some, because we started off with 60-something, right? So, yeah, pretty much got a full stack of coin out of that deal-ish.
Gratitude.
Not bad. Okay, let's check his inventory. We want to look at food. We'll buy these just so we can make the seeds, and I'm going to buy those for the same reason. We don't need to buy any of the, well, we could buy these just to make bacon and eggs back at the home. Let's look at the secret stash really quick. See if he's got anything good here. Shotgun choke mod, pistol, two green pistols. Okay. And then we'll take a look at his overall inventory. I'm looking for an auger, more than almost anything else, really, at this point. I have just about everything else I need except for an auger. Shotgun schematic. Yeah, that's all the stuff I sold him. Y'all come back now. You hear? Okay. Let's take a look at his vending machine. So we will take all food and most candy. We don't need those, really. We'll take the smoothie as well. Okay, nice. So we made a beautiful chunk of change. A full stack, in fact. And we have two full stacks back at the base. So we have over 60,000 coin now, which isn't bad. All right, let's scoot on over to, I'm just doing a quick look here to see if there's any corn patches. But I'll meet you guys over at the Desert Trader next. All right, we have a minute and 41 seconds left. We don't have anything to sell to him, but let's take a look and see if he's got any seeds for us. No, he's got more potatoes, yeah. So let's buy those, and we might as well buy the eggs, too. Don't need the animal fat. Take a look at his secret stash really quick. Sniper Volume 4, we will buy that. We don't need the motorcycle chassis schematic. Okay, let's look at his overall stash here. He's got a green iron crossbow. We got a purple compound bow that we found recently back at the base, which is a pretty nice find. Okay, nothing there that we need.
Safe travels.
Okay, well, we got the Sniper Volume 4, so reload rifles 10% faster. That's nice. So we'll use that up. And let's check his vending machine. We got a nice... Oh, have I... I never checked that. Really? Did I check these? That's a working one. Would have been a nice find in the very early game. We'll take that. Don't care about that. Okay. So we'll take Adam. We can start making coffee, so I'm not going to keep buying it. Good. There's some more sugar butts and eye candy. All right. So let's kind of look around here in the desert town for corn or potatoes. Because like I said, I haven't deliberately looked for those things. So I could have driven by it many times and, you know, just ignored it. So let's take a look and see if we can find anything. I found that corn patch. I think I'm going to time-lapse that part for you guys when I edit. So in case I decide not to for some reason later on, I found a pretty good-sized corn patch coming out of the other town. And we got 87 corn there, which is nice. Hold still! And don't back up against a cactus either. That's not good for your health. Okay. Let's see. We probably better pop one of these. Yeah, let's take one of those. I'm going to save that for my next mining session, so we'll take one of these. All right, let's harvest these guys. Might as well. I'm not going way out of my way to collect rotten meat, but I am collecting it because we can make hobo stew now. Alrighty. We kind of need to do this. So, oh, we got a quest over there? What quest is that? The church? I don't see the church. I mean, there's a church over there, but that's like the big cathedral church. I'm confused. Oh, it's right here. Oh, right. That's the Victorian house quest. Okay. Well, you know what? We'll do that later. I'm not really here today to do quests. That's not what our goal is. So we're looking for potato patches and corn patches and really anything else we can find that we still need for the garden. So let's get all the way kind of to the corner of town here, which I think is here. Yeah. So, yeah, what I'm going to do is just kind of do like a tightening circle and just go around and look and see, you know, if we can find some more corner potatoes. All right, let's quickly stop into Trader Hugh here. There was, I didn't find anything in the desert town. No more corn patches or potato patches or anything like that. All right, let's take a look at your inventory. Let's look at this first. He's got a yellow marksman rifle. That's not too bad. But I don't think we really need that. Oh, grenade schematic. We don't know it. Yeah, because it would tell us that. End night stalker. Boasts you 10% more damage at night.
Thank God you're done browsing. Out of room. Next time here. I'll charge you for that.
Where did that go? Oh, right here. Okay. We kind of have to hurry because we're running out of daylight, and I want to get to that last trader. We want to buy that.
That's all you're going to buy. I'll let you show yourself out.
I'm going to show you out in a minute. Shut up. okay, I think that's it from Secret Stash that we want. All right, let's take a look at seeds. I'm not going to pay $108 for a can of shim. No way, no how. Okay, let's just take a look at his overall inventory really quick, and then we got to get the hell out of here. Robotic sledges. Okay, that's
Alrighty, it. All then. On your way.
We will buy both of those. We'll buy that. Don't need anything else. Okay, we got to hurry. I think we'll be okay. We just got to scooch. I'm going to put a few things in here. I forgot the cell. This is our good one here. Okay, let's put that up there. I didn't sell this one because I thought we had it. Oh, I didn't check to see if he wanted those wrenches too. Let's just do that really quick. We should be okay, time-wise. Let's just pop the sugar butts. What the hell, right?
Oh, I guess you're not so bad. Just sold it to him, damn it.
Oh, can't take me anywhere. All right, whatever. Let's just go. Let's sell this one first because that one's more valuable. Oh, for Pete's sake. Old guy, can't take me anywhere. Okay, so yeah, we're going to sell that to him too. Yeah, that sucks that I did that.
Time to move on.
I will. Okay, let's go.
We sell only the best merchandise.
Okay, let's see what he's got. Secret stash. I was learning elixir, forgetting elixir. Okay, food items. You got an awesome sauce. Can we make that?
You have a great day now.
We can make that. What do we need for it? Ah, yeah, okay, I'm not buying it if we can make it. It wouldn't make a whole lot of sense, would it? Oh, yes! Score, you guys! There it is, auger schematic, finally. Damn, son. All right, we're buying that. We are buying that. I'm not going to buy this because we'll just spec into it when the time comes. So there's no point in buying the recipe. You know, if we come across it, we'll come across it. But, oh, nice. I was hoping that's what we would find. We're going to buy both of these. Precious gems. Yeah, okay. All right, good. That was what we came for. Well, that and seeds. Oh, man, that was amazing. Okay, I'm super happy old guy right now. Super happy old guy. Just still looking. Okay, good deal.
Pleasure.
Look at that, you guys.
Work yourself out there.
Finally, an auger schematic. And we can make a blue one, too, because of our mad skills. All right, let's... No. Oh. Come on, fun pimps. Are you sure you want to scrap this? It wouldn't be that hard for you to put that on schematics. Please, please. It's just too damn easy to do. Ugh. Okay, that was. I'm glad I caught myself. I'm a bit pissed. We already made one stupid mistake. We don't want to make two right now. Oh, man. We can make an auger. That is so fucking awesome. Okay, let's see. Ah, yeah. We've got all that stuff. Easy. Easy peasy. Oh, man. I'm so stoked. Okay, cool. All right, well, let's see. Same thing. I'm gonna just kind of drive around this town and look for corn and potatoes. I know there's nothing up to the north because I kind of came through and paid attention, so I'm just gonna kind of look quickly around the rest of the town. I haven't really spent much time in the southern part of this town, so let's just kind of see what we can find here. There's a little tiny bit of corn right there. We actually might have all the corn we need by now, too, but any extra we get is just bonus. Might as well grab the blueberries, too. Alright, guys, well, I think we're probably out of time in this episode. I've kind of lost track of how long it is, but I'm going to do a bunch of editing on it anyway. So I think I'm going to let you go here, and then in the next episode, we'll just continue on looking for, you know, more corn, potatoes, that sort of thing, And we might go back here. The problem with right here is there's no highway going south. So, you know, we'd have to cut across country, and sometimes you can get into some pretty bad terrain doing that. What I was thinking I could do is go to this town, look for corn and potato patches, and then hopefully this one has a highway that'll start heading south. Because usually these maps kind of have one long circular highway. Not in every case, though. And maybe do that. But anyways, hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Man, we found the auger, guys. That's awesome. So fucking awesome. So we found the auger. I'm very happy about that. And we'll just pick up in the next episode, like I said, doing some more exploring, uncovering more of the map, looking for potatoes, really, is what we need to find now. But we did buy some, so that's two more seeds worth right there, which isn't bad. And that's it. So thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment, share the video, and we'll catch you in the next episode. Bye-bye.